So friends, today we'll be discussing about the dupe characteristics of the governor of generators on board the ship. So before that, I would like you to subscribe my channel. Now friends, actually the percentage speed droop of the governor of a generator is given by no load speed minus full load speed by no load speed into 100. Now suppose, in other words, we can say no load frequency minus full load frequency by no load frequency into 100. So suppose if a generator no load frequency, it runs at 62 Hz and the full load frequency is 57 Hz and the no load and the full load frequency is 62 Hz, then 62 minus 57 minus is 5 by 62 into 100, it comes approx 8%. But the desired droop characteristic of should be between 2 to 4%. Now friend, let us try to understand the concept of this droop. Now friend, we are having two generators on the ship having the kilowatt rating 500 and 500 each. Now actually the generators are actually they are ratified as in terms of KVA. Now KVA is apparent power and there is kilowatt, this is the real power, and there is KVAR, that is the reactive power. I will deal with KVAR, kilowatt and KVA in a different tutorial. Now here, for the sake of our understanding, I am just considering the real power, that is the useful power, that is the kilowatt. Now friend, this is the characteristic curve of the generator number 1 and this is the characteristic curve of generator number 2. Now for the generator number 1, we have the at 0 kilowatt, that is the no load frequency 61, and at 500 kilowatt, that is the full load, for generator number 1 we have the frequency 58. Similarly, in the second generator, we are having at 0 kilowatt, that is no load, at no load frequency 62, and on at 500 kilowatt, that is full load, at full load we have the frequency 57. So here we can see that as the load is increasing, the frequency is decreasing, that is the speed is also decreasing of the generator. Now friend, these two generators, the characteristic curve of these two generators we are having here. Now this is the operating frequency of the ship, that is the ship which requires, how much frequency? It requires 60 Hz frequency. So the operating frequency is 60 Hz. Now friend, let us try to understand all these concepts step by step. Now this is the first triangle, the characteristic curve of generator number 1. So in this triangle, that is BGD. So triangle BGD for generator number 1, we have a triangle BGD. Here this angle alpha is subtended by this GB line. So this tan alpha is equal to, this is the perpendicular BD and the base is GD. So tan alpha we can write BD by GD. Now BD is what? 61 Hz minus 58 Hz. So that's why BD by GD, 61 Hz minus 58 Hz. And the base is GD. This is 500 minus 0. This is 500 kilowatt minus 0. So we are having tan alpha is equal to 3 Hz by 500 kilowatt. Now the now we consider the second triangle, this. Now here we are having tan alpha is equal to BC by base, that is EC. Now this one is, BC is how much? BC is 61 minus 60, that is 1, and EC is how much? EC is X minus 0. So that's what I've written. Triangle BC, BEC, tan alpha is equal to BC by EC. Alpha is equal to tan inverse of BC by EC. Tan inverse of 61 minus 60 by x into 0. X minus 0. Now, friend, this is the, these alpha, both are alpha will be equal because these are two parallel lines. This is the parallel line to this. So this one is actually, these are the alternate angles. So we can write that we can equate 1 and 2. So friend, we can equate both the equations of the two triangles, that is alpha is equal to tan inverse of 3 by 500. This is the first equation, and the second equation is alpha is equal to tan inverse of, that is we can 1 by x, tan inverse of 1 by x. So x is equal to 500 by 3, that is equal to 166.67 kilowatt. Alpha is, one is alpha, we can equate it here. So we can write it that tan inverse of 3 by 400, that is 3 by, tan inverse is cancelled, 3 by 400 by 1 by x. So we got x is equal to 500 by 3, that is 166.67 kilowatt. It is sharing at 60 hertz. So at 60 hertz it is sharing how much? It is sharing 166 by 0.7. So friends, now for generator number 2, let us see for the generator number 2. In this here we can see in the triangle AKJ, this is beta, we are taking angle beta. Now tan beta is equal to, perpendicular is how much? 62 minus 57 by base is how much? This is 500 minus 0 kilowatt. So how much that here I've written, beta is equal to tan inverse of 5 by 500, that is 62 minus 57. So friend, in triangle ACF we have tan beta is equal to 62 minus 60, that is 2 divided by y minus 0. So we are writing here tan beta is equal to 62 minus 60 divided by y minus 0, that is y minus 0. Now tan inverse of we can equate both the equations, equation 1 and equation 2 here. Tan inverse of 5 by 500 is equal to tan inverse of 2 by y. So we can tan inverse gets cancelled here, and then we have 5y is equal to 1000 and y is equal to 1000 by 5, that is we have 200 kilowatt. So as we are seeing here, load shared by first generator is 166.67, and the load shared by another generator is 200 kilowatt. So friends, as we are seeing, generator number 2 is sharing more load, and generator number 1 is sharing less load. 166.67 for generator 1 and 200 for generator number 2. So we can see also here that the droop of the generator number 1 is, see, 61 minus 58 divided by 61 into 100, that is approximately 5%. And for generator number 2 we are having 62 minus 57 by 62 into 100, that is 8.1%. So as the percentage droop of generator number 2 is more, so it is sharing more load, and the percentage droop of generator number 1 is less, so it is sharing less load. So now friend, in this second case we have two generators having equal droop setting, that is the no load frequency of number 1 is also 61, and the full load frequency, that is at 500 kilowatt, this generator will be having 57 hertz. And for the generator number 2 we are having the same no load frequency at 0 kilowatt, that is 61 hertz, and at 500 kilowatt it will be having 57 hertz. So in a similar way we will derive the two equations for alpha from in triangle AFC and triangle ADB, and we will equate it. Then we will get X is equal to 125 kilowatt. In the similar way, the way we did previously, in these two triangles ACI and ABE, we will equate for the beta angle. That is, beta in the first case we are having in the ACI triangle as tan inverse 4/500. So, and beta in case of the second case we are having 1/Y. So we equating, we will get Y is equal to 125. That is, this is 125 and this is X is also 125 kilowatt. So we are, as we are seeing here, when the droop setting is equal, they are sharing equal load. So now friends, I want to discuss one more thing here, that this is the frequency curve of a generator having no droop. That is, at no load it is having the same frequency, and at high load also, when it is taken on load, that is 100% load, it will be showing 60 hertz frequency. At no load also it is showing 60 hertz frequency. So 60 hertz frequency. So this is actually, this A will be called as isochronous characteristic. So A is the isochronous characteristic of the governor of the generator, and the B is shows the speed droop characteristic. So in the speed droop characteristic, as we had already discussed here, at no load frequency is 60 hertz, but it is at full load, at 100%, it is, the load is getting decreased to 58 hertz. So now we will discuss what is load sharing and the necessity of droop. Friends, here as we are seeing here, this is a generator 1 having here the zero load frequency is 61 hertz, and this is the full load frequency, and this is the operating frequency of the ship, that is a 60 hertz. And for generator number 2, here we are having this generator number 2 having now at present the frequency is 60.5 hertz, and this is the zero load frequency, and 59 hertz at full load, 100% load for generator number 2. Now we are having this crossing point. Now this crossing point is meeting at this point. At this point, so here the frequency is suppose 60.25. So what we need to do is that we will further increase the speed of, so speed control of the G2 is increased to take the part of the load. So here we are going to, therefore we will try to increase the frequency speed of the generator number 2. So see friend, here we have increased it, so the crossing point has shifted a bit in the left, and in the generator number one, for the generator number 1, we in the frequency actually it is 60.5. now here what we are doing is that speed control of G1, generator number 1, is reduced to give more load. Okay, in this we are reducing the load, reducing the speed through the speed control, we are reducing the speed of the generator number 1, so to give more load on G2. So we are giving more load, and we are increasing the speed of generator number 1 to take more load. So the crossing point is shifting, and at one point will come where we will get a 60 hertz frequency, which will be common to both the generators, and we will have a synchronizing effect. One more concept I would like to discuss, my friend, here this G1 and G2. If governor characteristics are isochronous, then there will be no crossing points along the characteristics of, and the load sharing will be unstable. So as we are seeing here, we both generators, we don't have any droop. For generator number 1, suppose this is the frequency of 60.25 hertz, it is also 60.25 hertz. So this 60.25,
we are not getting any crossing point the way we were getting here. So we were shifting this crossing point in such a way that the needed, the required frequency of the ship, that is 60 hertz, will be at one point, this will coincide on this one, so that we will get a 60 hertz frequency common to both the generators having the equal sharing load. So here, as we are not getting any crossing point. Now friends, there is a speed droop knob on the governor, on the generator on the ship. Actually, the speed droop knob that controls the droop setting for fine adjustment when load sharing is required to be altered between different alternators.